श्रीसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिप्राणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिनी व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ वनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्यजाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशमुमुक्षुर्वै शरणं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आम्ना यान्ति संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। ओके, सो दि 15th अधिकरण 26 सूत्र इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड बाय सेइंग यथा पूर्वम् विद्यासन्निधौ श्रुतस्यापि मन्त्रादेहे विद्यायाम् अनावश्यकत्वात् अनुपसंहार उक्तः। सो व्हाट वाज डन अर्लियर, पूर्वपक्षी इज सेइंग इवन इन दि सन्निधि प्रॉक्सिमिटी ऑफ विद्या उपासना श्रुतस्य अपि मंत्रादेह मंत्र कर्म दीज वेर हर्ड इन दी प्रॉक्सिमिटी ऑफ इन दी श्रुति इटसेल्फ। साक्षात इन दी श्रुति इट वाज हर्ड दीज मंत्रास एंड कर्मास दे वेर हर्ड इन प्रॉक्सिमिटी टू दी विद्या उपासना। इवन देन विद्यायाम अनावश्यकत्वात् बिकॉज दे हैव एब्सोल्युटली नो बिजनेस इन that upasana, no connection at all. Therefore, anupasamhara ukta. Therefore, there should be no clubbing together. You should not mix up mantras and karmas, even if they are proximal to the vidya, into the vidya, where there is no connection seen. Anavashyakatvat. It's all futile. Tatha, similarly what? Tatha, kvachit hanasannidav shrutasya api upadhanasya antarena अपि उपादानं तूष्णीं हानसंभवेन अनावश्यकत्वात् अनुपसंहार इति दृष्टांत संगत्या इदमाह। पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट सिमिलरली इज द केस तथा क्वचित सम प्लेसेस यू हैव व्हाट ही इज गोइंग टू कोट दीज प्लेसेस वी विल सी द इलैबोरेशन इन द वृत्ति बिकॉज सूत्र कैन नॉट बी अंडरस्टूड अदरवाइज वी विल सी द लॉन्ग सूत्र एंड द लॉन्ग वृत्ति ऑल्सो एंड देर आर टू वर्णकास हियर two descriptions of the sutra as well, two interpretations of the sutra. It's quite complex in that sense. So, tatha kvachit hanasannidhau shrutasya api upadhanasya. The concept is very simple, but the examples given from Purvamimamsa, they are a little tricky to understand. So, hanasannidhau shrutasya api upadhanasya. The upadhana is accepting or taking up something, and it is in the sannidhi of what? It is shruta. It is heard in the same shruti. You hear the acceptance of punya and papa. Punya and papa, the vidwan upasaka as well as the jnani, the brahma upasaka and the brahma jnani, both give up their papa and punya also. Punya papa also. Especially in jnana, there is punya papa given up. Upasaka may be given up papa, may be giving up only papa. But then acceptance by others, whom does this punya go to? Whom does this papa of the jnani go to? In Tattva Bodha, we have seen that the jnani, Brahma jnani, is to be worshipped by the sadhakas. He is to be worshipped if one wants phala, one wants punya, one wants sukha. Because Brahmaveda Brahmaiva Bhavati, the Brahma Jnani is Brahma itself. He is Paramatma in Sharira. Therefore, Sakshat Parameshwara being available, the sadhakas should worship the Jnani for their own benefit, not for the benefit of the Jnani. Now what happens there? This jnani since he is Brahma, what happens to his karma now? Sanchita is burnt, and that agami which karma which accumulates, he is not thinking of himself as a karta. He is not a karta bhukta. Therefore, the agami karma being done due to the prarabdha of the sharira of the jnani, the agami karma, meaning the karma which is done after jnanodaya, that karma cannot accrue to the jnani. So his entire punya papa, punya and papa both will unknowingly get done because the sharira is continuing, and any activity, all activities cannot be neutral. So any activity is going to bring some punya or papa. So whom does the jnani's punya and papa go to? So Tattva Bodha also says that the those who worship and praise the jnani, to them the jnani's punya goes, because jnani does not claim it, and the papa goes to those who torture or trouble the jnani or insult the jnani, because it is as good as insulting, as good as praising the Lord, or as bad as insulting the Lord. So the sadhakas or the devotees are going to get this punya, and enemies are going to get the papa. That is the upadana, acceptance. It is heard in the Shruti itself. Shrutasya api upadanasya han kutra shrutasya hana sannidho. Hana is giving up. The jnani is giving up his punya and papa, and others are picking up. Now hana sannidho shrutasya, jnani giving up the punya papa is heard in one shruti. Kvachit. Upadana is not heard. And upadanasya antarena api upadanam tushnim hana sambhavena anavashyakatvat. Even if others are not picking up the punya papa, jnani can just drop his punya papa. Therefore, the Purvapakshi is saying, similar is the case as to you hear the upadana nearby. In the hana sannidhi it is heard. Shrutasya, somewhere it is not heard at all. Somewhere it is heard. So somewhere it may be mentioned that the others get the punya papa. Somewhere it may be mentioned that the jnani drops the punya papa. Somewhere it may be mentioned as to jnani drops and the others pick up. All sorts of possibilities are there in the shruti, various shrutis. So now Purvapakshi is saying, kvachit hana sannidhau shrutasya api upadanasya, where the upadana is heard. It is in proximity to the hana. So jnani gives up, and proximal to that statement is that others pick up punya papa. So antarane api upadanam, even without their acceptance being mentioned there, tushnim hana sambhavena, without others knowing, I mean tushnim, tushnim literally means silently, without any expectancy of anything else, no dependency is needed, jnani can just drop the punya papa. Hana sambhavena anavashyakatvat. There is no need for the upadana, others accepting at all. Jnani gives up punya papa, who cares whether others pick up or not? That is the, you know, perspective rather. There is no necessity when jnani has nothing to do with the punya papa. Why do we care whether the others pick up the punya papa or not? There is no need for that connection at all. Therefore, anupasamhara iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. Purvapakshi says this guna upasamhara need not be done. As in upadana guna, upasamhara need not be done in the hana, where hana is mentioned, and in proximity, upadana may or may not be mentioned. You don't need it at all. This is the exemplified to the earlier adhikarana example given by the Siddhanti. What has been given by the Siddhanti in the earlier adhikarana, that is taken as a, I mean the answer given is taken as an example, and it is extended to another place. Therefore, it is a drishtanta sangati. There is an example and the exemplified connection between these two adhikaranas. Hanya adhikaranam comes up, and भगवान सूत्रकार ऐसे हानौ तु उपायन शब्द शेषत्वात् कुशाच्छन्दस्तुत्युपगान वत्तरुक्तम्। हानौ तु उपायन शब्द शेषत्वात् कुशाच्छन्दस्तुत्युपगान वत्तरुक्तम्। लॉन्ग सूत्र। हानौ सप्तमी एक वचन, हानौ तु उपायन शब्द शेषत्वात् कुशा छंद स्तुति उपगानवत, दैट इज सिंगल वर्ड, कुशा छंद स्तुत्युपगानवत तद उक्तम। दिस इज द पदच्छेद। इट हैज बीन स्टेटेड तद उक्तम इन मीमांसा सूत्र। इट हैज बीन स्टेटेड, व्हाट हैज बीन स्टेटेड वी विल सी एज एन एग्जांपल, व्हाट हैज बीन गिवन, व्हाट, वत, लाइक समथिंग, व्हाट इज दैट, कुशा छंद स्तुति एंड उपगान, फोर examples are given, kushavat, chandavat, stutivat and upaganavat. These are the four examples given. Mimamsa Sutra, Jaimini Maharshi, there he explains it, therefore taduktam, this has been stated there. What is this example used for, that, what is this simile used for by the Siddhanti there? Hanam tu upayana शब्द शेषत्वात्। सो वॉट इज इट मीन्स इज दैट वील लुक एट अ सिंपल एक्सप्लेनेशन राइट नाउ एंड डिटेल्स वील सी इन दी वृत्ति। ज्ञानी गिव्स अ पुण्य पाप, देर फोर ज्ञानिना पुण्य पाप कर्म हानौ तु, वेन दी ज्ञानी गिव्स अप दी पुण्य पाप, सती सप्तमी हानौ तु उपायन शब्द शेषत्वात्। Meaning what, this hanau tu, if you just take jnanina punya karma hanau satyam, when jnani has given up punya and papa, meaning kevala hanau, this is a kaivalya vachi, just hani is heard. In the shruti, when you are reading or chanting, what happens is that some meaning is understood there. Especially when we have studied the meaning earlier, then as soon as Vyakrana Ityadi has been studied, then what happens is that some understanding takes place. And when this Hani, meaning the dropping of Punya Papa, is heard, then there is an Akanksha, there is a dependency. Oh, Jnani has given up his, dropped his Punya Papa, then who picks it up? This Akanksha is pending. So, Upayana Shabda Sheshatva, there is a dependency. When the, just the hani, kevala hanau satyam, when only hani is understood, then upayana shabda, upayana shabda sheshatvam is there. There is an expectancy. Oh, who takes up? For example, if you have a statement as to what, Ramaha Ayodhya Nagarat Gacchati, Rama is leaving Ayodhya Nagara, then what is the Akanksha? Where is he going? Somebody says, I am leaving this place. For example, my friend said he is leaving his job. Obviously, the expectancy, there is a dependency, Akanksha is there. Oh, where is he going? Where is he going? So, Rama is going from Ayodhya Nagara, that statement, although it is independently complete, there is a Vakya Shesha, there is an Akanksha, where is he going? सो कुत्र गच्छति इति आकांक्षा जायेत। सिमिलरली हियर व्हेन द ज्ञानी ड्रॉप्स पुण्य पाप देयर इज एन एक्सपेक्टेंसी, आकांक्षा इज देयर, हु पिक्स अप, वेयर डज इट गो, व्हाट हैपेंस, ऑल दिस आकांक्षा, इट्स अ मनुष्य स्वभाव, देयरफॉर उपायन शब्द शेषत्वात् तस्य, हानि शब्दस्य, इट हैज अ डिपेंडेंसी ऑन उपायन शब्द, हु इज गोइंग टू पिक इट अप, लाइक वॉट, कुशा छंद स्तुति उपगान वत तदुक्तम। जैमिनी महर्षि हैज एक्सप्लेन दिस, वील सी दीज मीनिंग, लाइक कुशा, कुशा इज दी इज अ पार्ट ऑफ दी, कुशा इज अ ग्रास ऑल्सो, एंड वील सी वॉट इट इज, एक्चुअली इट इज शुड बी मेड फ्रॉम विच ट्री एट्सेट्रा, सम पार्ट्स ऑफ द ट्री आर कॉल्ड कुशा देर, सो यर नॉट कुशा ग्रास बट कुशा इज अ फॉर जप संख्या, हाउ मेनी मालाज आर डन फॉर दैट, the kusha is kept and you count with kusha, after every mala kusha is set aside एंड नंबर ऑफ कुशाज आर एक्यूमुलेटेड इनिशियली एज टू हाउ मच काउंट, हाउ मेनी मालाज आर टू बी डन. सो विच व्हेन यू से कुशा हैज टू बी यूज फॉर जप संख्या, देन विच वुड शुड बी यूज, विच वृक्ष वुड शुड बी यूज, दैट काइंड ऑफ आकांक्षा कम्स अप. सो सच एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन. छंद, छंदस इज ऑल्सो वन एग्जाम्पल, स्तुति इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल, एंड उपगान. आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू रिपीट दीज बिकॉज there's a long explanation needed for each, so we'll see that in the vritti, the explanation for each of these. So one example we already seen, kusha. So when kusha is heard elsewhere in one shakha, in another shakha which kusha is explained, from which tree it has to be made, therefore upasamhara is done. Similarly, when the purvapakshi is saying there is no apeksha, there is no dependency at all, he has said अनावश्यकत्वा, देर इज आवश्यकता. वाई? बिकॉज आकांक्षा इज देर. वेन यू हियर कुशा फॉर जप संख्या, विच वृक्ष कुशा शुड बी, शुड इट बी. सो इफ दैट इज एंसर्ड इन अनदर शाखा, दैट शुड बी ब्रॉट इन हियर. देर इज अ प्रत्यभिज्ञा ऑल्सो. इफ यू हैव हर्ड इट इन द अदर शाखा, देन एज सून एज यू हियर इन स्वशाखा ऑल्सो, देर इज अ प्रत्यभिज्ञा, एंड देर बाय उपसंहार शुड बी डन. सो पूर्व पक्षी सेइंग नो उपसंहार शुड बी डन in the case of upadana heard in the close proximity of hani also, or hana. Hanya and hani have the same meaning, whereas siddhanti is saying upasamhara should be done because there is an akanksha, there is a dependency, vakya shesha is there, that is the sutra artha. The long vritti follows. Atra purvapakshe vidya stuti prakarsha siddhihi, siddhanti tu upadanasya atra upasamhara विद्या स्तुति प्रकर्ष सिद्धि इति फलभेद. सो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस हियर? द सिंपलेस्ट ऑफ द पूर्वपक्ष एंड सिद्धांती फला इज एक्सप्लेन. पूर्वपक्षी सेज दैट विद्या स्तुति प्रकर्ष असिद्धि, द उपासना बीइंग प्रेज्ड, उपासना एज वेल एज ज्ञान. विद्या हैज बोथ मीनिंग्स हियर, ब्रह्म विद्या हैज ब्रह्म उपासना ऑल्सो, एंड फॉर अवर केस इन सिद्धांत, परम सिद्धांत, इट इज ब्रह्म ज्ञान. So there, vidya stuti, brahma vidya stuti, prakarsha, prakarsha is eminence of that, is the eminence of the vidya stuti, the praise is absolute. That kind of a praise, is it established or not? Purvapakshi says asiddhi, it is not established, there is no such eminence of praise of brahma vidya. Siddhanti says there is definitely eminence of praise, meaning prakarsha, prakarsha siddhi is there. Of what? Of stuti, stuti of vidya, brahma vidya. And why is it so? The hetu given is upadanasya atra upasamharat, because upadana, that, see, brahma vidya giving punya and papa, an end to the punya and papa, brahma vidya bringing an end to the punya papa for the jnani, उपासक ज्ञानी, इज अ प्रेज ऑल राइट, स्तुति. बट वेन विल इट बी एब्सोल्यूट? इफ यू लुक एट इट, इट विल बी एब्सोल्यूट. ओके, ही इज ब्रह्म ज्ञानी, सो वॉट? ही हैज ड्रॉप्ड हिज पुण्य पापा, सो वॉट? वॉट डू आई गेट? एनी वन कैन से दैट ही इज अ ब्रह्म ज्ञानी. ओके, वॉट एम आई गोइंग टू गेट फ्रॉम दैट? आई एम गेटिंग नथिंग फ्रॉम हिज ब्रह्म ज्ञान. बट यू आर गेटिंग, इफ द श्रुति सेज दैट यू हु इज हैविंग एक्सेस टू सच अ ब्रह्म ज्ञानी can praise him, can serve him, can worship him and get punya. And you who is in close proximity, you are looking at the sharira and then you start insulting him or treating him badly, then you will get papa. When this kind of a thing is mentioned by the shruti and you can connect, then what happens? Then there is absolute praise. Not absolute in that sense, but I am just explaining prakarsha. There is eminence of praise. The praise becomes increased. The quality of praise, or praise the, is glorification is more. And we have seen this arthavada or the stuti. All these need not be just stuti, meaning not meaningless. That they are meaningless. They need not be meaningless. It can be meaningful, it can be literal also. So it can be a statement of fact as well. One thing is that some praise is done फॉर द साधक हैज टू बी अट्रैक्टेड टू दैट ब्रह्म विद्या एंड इट कैन बी लिटरल ऑल्सो इट इज जस्ट अ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ फैक्ट फॉर दोज हु आर लैकिंग श्रद्धा दे थिंक दैट इट इज अ मियर ग्लोरिफिकेशन इट इज नॉट अ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ फैक्ट दोज हु हैव श्रद्धा नो दैट ओ दिस इज ट्रू सो फॉर देम इट बिकम्स अ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ फैक्ट सो इति फलभेद अत्र शाट्यायनिनः पठन्ति अत्र अत्र शाट्यायनिनः शाट्यायनिनः शाखा सो दोज हु फॉलो दैट दे पठन्ति दे व्हाट डू दे चैंट तस्य पुत्रा दायम उपयन्ति सुहृदस्साधुकृत्यां द्विषन्तः पापकृत्यां इति सो इन दी सो दे चैंट दैट तस्य पुत्र तस्य ब्रह्मज्ञानिनः ब्रह्म विद्या फॉलोअर उपासक ज्ञानी हिज चिल्ड्रन पुत्राः दायम उपयन्ति दे गेट धन दायम इज धन सो दे गेट दी धन सो द ज्ञानी चिल्ड्रन विल गेट वॉट दे विल गेट दी धन विच इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम एन अज्ञानी चिल्ड्रन सो वॉट आर दे गेटिंग इफ दी दे आर ज्ञानी चिल्ड्रन दे आर गेटिंग नथिंग देर आर पीपल हु थिंक दैट ओके इट बिलोंग्स टू द सेम फैमिली देयर फोर यू हैव टू वर्शिप दीज पीपल ऑल्सो इट इज नॉट ट्रू Because Ajnani children will also get the property and the Jnani children will get the property. If there is a property. They may partake of his fame also. Oh, he was my father and all that. But really Suhruda, those who are well-wishers of the Jnani, worshippers, well-wishers, devotees, why Suhruda? You can take anything. Shobhanam, Hrityasya, Suhruda. So those who have a good heart, meaning well-meaning, those who are well-meaning towards the jnani, they attain sadhukrityam upayanti, sadhukrityam upayanti, meaning the punya of the jnani they accrue. Dvishanta, those who hate or dislike and then insult the jnani, ill-treat the jnani, dvishanta, they attain what? They dvishanta papakrityam. उपयन्ति तस्य तस्य ज्ञानिनः दे अटेन दिस ब्रह्म विद्या उपासक ज्ञानी पाप कर्म इति दिस इज हर्ड इन दि शाट्यायनी शाट्यायन शाखा तांडिनस्तु वेर एज दि तांडी फॉलोअर व्हाट अबाउट दैट अश्व इव रोमाणि विधूय पापम इत्याद्यामनन्ति सो दि तांडिनः दे दि तांडी दे हैव अश्व इव रोमाणि अश्व इज अ हॉर्स इव रोमाणि रोमाणि आर दि दि हेयर सो दि दि हॉर्स मूव्स यू नो यू मे हैव सीन दि डॉग यू नो काइंड ऑफ ट्रेम्बल्स एंड देन ड्रॉप्स ऑल दि हेयर नॉट ऑल दि हेयर सम हेयर दि डॉग ऑल्सो ड्रॉप सिमिलर अश्व इव रोमाणि दि हॉर्सेस हेयर आर लॉन्ग Especially, you know, after the head, the neck area, there you have long hair. And the horse drops. Vidhuya papam. So like the horse dropping his hair, its hair, Jnani also vidhuya papam. Having dropped all the papa. Drops papa has been mentioned. Papa can be seen as upalakshana for punya also for in the case of Brahma Jnani. Ityadyamananti. This is what they chant in their own shakha. What about the Atharvanika? In the Atharva Shaka, Tatha Atharvanika, Atharvanika, Tatha Vidwan, Punya Pape, Vidhuya, Ityadyamananti. So there is Hana heard here, Vidhuya, having dropped out Punya and Papa. So Vidwan, having dropped out Punya and Papa, this is what they chant. So in the earlier first case, what we have heard, Shatyayana Shaka, there we have heard that the Our focus is Surudaha and Dushanta. What do they attain? They attain Punya and Papa. So there is an Upadana heard there. Hana is heard in Tandina. For Tandina, Hana is heard. And for Atharvinaka also, the Hana is heard. Hani or Hana of Punya Papa. Tatra Shatyayane Shrutavu Punya Papaya Upadana Matram Shrutam. So we just hear there in the Shatyayana Shaka. As to Shatyayani Shruti, what do we hear? Only acceptance of Punya and Papa by the others. Tachya Tyagam Vinana Sambhavati Iti Punya Papa Tyaga Akshipyate. नाउ हाउ विल दे एक्सेप्ट दी पुण्य एंड पापा ऑफ हुज तस्य तस्य कस्य तस्य ज्ञानी ना दैट ज्ञानीज पापा एंड पुण्य दे एक्सेप्ट व्हेन दी ज्ञानी डजंट ड्रॉप दी पुण्य पापा देन हाउ कैन दी अदर्स एक्सेप्ट इट सो ओनली एक्सेप्टेंस हैज बीन मेंशन व्हेन ओनली एक्सेप्टेंस हैज ओनली उपादान इज मेंशन देन व्हाट तच्च उपादानम त्यागम विना न संभवति दैट उपादान मात्रम केवल उपादानम जस्ट एक्सेप्टेंस ऑफ पुण्य एंड पापा बाय अदर्स इज नॉट पॉसिबल विदाउट ज्ञानी गिविंग दी पुण्य एंड पापा फर्स्ट गिविंग अप देयरफॉर व्हाट देयर इज एन आकांक्षा ऑल राइट सेज दी पूर्वपक्षी तथा तच्च त्यागम विना न संभवति इति पुण्य पाप त्याग आक्षिप्यते गिविंग अप ऑफ पुण्य एंड पापा आक्षेप कैन बी डन एज देयर इज अ डिपेंडेंसी सो यू कैन थिंक दैट ज्ञानी इज गिविंग अप देन ओनली दे आर पिकिंग अप दी पुण्य पाप यत्र तु तांड्याथर्वण वाक्यद्वये पुण्य पाप त्याग मात्रं श्रुतं तत्र त्यक्तयोः उपादानम् अन्यत्र श्रुतं अत्र उपसंहर्तव्यं न वा इति संदेहे नेति पूर्वपक्ष Whereas in the case of the other two shakhas, mantras which are mentioned, there only hana has been mentioned. When only hana is mentioned, upadana akanksha itself is not there, says the Purva Pakshi. Why? Because it is possible to drop the punya papa. In the case of picking up the punya papa, when it is mentioned that his children pick up the dhana, if the father is not going to give up the dhana, then how are the children going to pick up? So obviously when you say that if the father is alive and he is giving up the dhana, that is one possibility. Or if the father is not alive, then anyway he has given up his dhana because he cannot carry it. Therefore he has given up. And thereby the putras, the children are picking up his dhana. They'll get the dhana. This is the understanding in the loka. Similarly what? The punya papa also has to be given up by the jnani, whether when alive or after death. But here it is in the case of the upasaka who is alive or the jnani who is alive. In that case, he has to give up the punya and papa for the others to pick up. This akanksha is there. However, when only giving up of punya and papa is mentioned, then there is no dependency at all. One can drop off the punya and papa. Just like Ashwaiva Rumani has mentioned, is there an akanksha when we say that the horse drops its hair? Horse shakes off its hair and the hairs fall off. The loose hair which is there, they fall off. So if the hair dropping is mentioned, do you have an akanksha of hair being picked up by the others? You don't have such akanksha at all. So Purva Pakshi is taking that angle and then he says, Yatra tu tandya and atharva, atharvana. So both, the second and the third quotes given, Yatra tu tandya atharvana, vakya dvaye punya papa tyagamatram shrutam. In those two vakyas of tandi and atharvana shruti, there punya and papa tyaga alone has been mentioned, kevala, matram. Tatra tyaktayoho upadanam anyatra, upadanam anyatra shrutam. So what has been given up, their picking up has been mentioned elsewhere. So if it is mentioned elsewhere in the same shakha or in the other shakha, that is not needed at all. Tyaktayo upadanam anyatra shrutam, where it is heard, in the same Shruti or elsewhere, if there is an acceptance of Punya and Papa mentioned, this Punya and Papa of the Jnani by others, picking up of that, Anyatra Shrutam, Atra Upasamhartavya Nava, should it be clubbed together as a Vakya Shesha in this mantra or not, in these two Vakyas, Tandi and Atharvana, where only Tyaga has been mentioned of Punya Papa, should you bring together and understand as to others are going to pick this up. When such a doubt comes up, ne iti purva paksha, na iti purva paksha. The purva paksha is saying no, there is no necessity at all. Anavashyaka. Siddhanti says, Siddhantastu, sautra tu shabda kaivalyavachi. That tu shabda in the sutra, hanau tu, that tu shabda is what? Kaivalyavachi, meaning only when hani is there. Hanau satyam tu, kevala hanau ityartha. केवल हानौ सत्याम When you say हानौ तु इट विल मीन केवल हानौ सत्याम सती सप्तमी. हानौ तु सत्याम मीन्स केवल हानौ सत्याम. वेन देर इज ओनली हानि ओनली ड्रॉपिंग ऑफ पुण्य एंड पापा देन वॉट तथा च केवल हानौ श्रुतायाम सत्याम तत्र उपादानम उपसंहर्तव्यम. वेन ओनली हानि इज हर्ड हाना और हानि इज हर्ड ओनली ड्रॉपिंग ऑफ पुण्य एंड पापा देन यू हैव टू ब्रिंग इन the acceptance of punya and papa by others also. Why so kutaha? Upayana shabda sheshatvad, because there is definitely an akanksha of upayana shabda. Oh, who is going to pick up that? Where is it mentioned? Where does it go? This akanksha remains, definitely remains. Tat sukruta duskrute vidunute tasya priya jnatayaha sukrutam upayanti apriya duskrutam iti कौशीतकी रहस्य हानसन्निधौ श्रूयमाणस्य हानशब्देन अपेक्षितस्य उपादानात्मक उपायन शब्दस्य हानं प्रति शेषत्वावगमान इत्यर्थः. सिद्धांति सेज दैट देयर इज एन एक्सपेक्टेंसी देयर इज एन आकांक्षा ऑफ हु पिक्स अप हिज पुण्य एंड पापा. सुकृत एंड दुष्कृत और पुण्य एंड पापा हु पिक्स अप. सो देयर कौशीतकी द उपनिषद इन देयर In that part, what do you have? You have the statement tat sukruta duskrute vidhunute. Tasya priyaha, those who are dear to the jnani. Why they are dear? Because they are well wishers of the jnani. What happens? Jnatayaha sukrutam upayanti. Priyaha jnatayaha. Those who are dear, they pick up what? Sukrutam, punya. Apriya, those who are not dear, meaning those who are not well-wishers, they pick up duskrutam iti kaushitaki rahasya. In the kaushitaki upanishad, hana sannidau shruyamanasya. Where there is hana, dropping of punya and papa, there itself in the proximal, there is a proximal statement, shruyamanasya, हान शब्देन अपेक्षितस्य विद्य हान देयर इज एन अपेक्षा ऑफ उपादान आल्सो उपादान आत्मक उपायन शब्दस्य द उपायन शब्द विच इज व्हाट इज द स्वरूप ऑफ दैट उपादान इज द स्वरूप गिविंग अप सॉरी पिकिंग अप एक्सेप्टेंस. सो व्हेन ओनली हान शब्द इज हर्ड देन अपेक्षित इज उपादान आत्मक उपायन शब्द. सो यू एक्सपेक्ट दी सम वर्ड उपायन शब्द विच हैज द मीनिंग ऑफ एक्सेप्टेंस. Who is accepting this punya and who is taking up, picking up the punya and papa? Hanam prati sheshatva avagamat. Since we know that there is a dependency of upayana shabda on the hana shabda. Or vice versa, hana shabda on upayana shabda in this case. Ityartha. Ashwaroma drishtantena vidutayoho punya papayo paratra avasthana sapekshatva paraihi upadanam avashyakamiti भाव आवश्यकम इति भाव. पूर्व पक्षी से इट इज नॉट नीडेड इट इज नीडेड अश्वरोम दृष्टांत. द अश्वरोम दृष्टांत इज देयर दैट द हॉर्स ड्रॉप्स इट्स हेयर एंड विदूतयोः पुण्य पापयो द गिवन अप पुण्य पाप सिमिलरली परत्र अवस्थान सापेक्षत्वात्. अश्वरोम दृष्टांत इज जस्ट अ दृष्टांत एज टू द मैनर इन विच द ज्ञानी इज ड्रॉपिंग द पुण्य एंड पापा. देर इज नो वन ऑन वन विद द अश्वरोमा दृष्टांत एज टू नो बडी हु इज पिकिंग अप द अश्वरोमा इज नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड देयर आकांक्षा इज नॉट देयर. दैट इज नॉट द एग्जाम्पल. द एग्जाम्पल इज द वे हाउ इजीली अनअफेक्टेड एंड अनकेयरिंगली हाउ द हॉर्स ड्रॉप्स ऑफ इट्स रोमा. सिमिलरली द ज्ञानी without any kartrutva, bhoktrutva at all, absolutely not feeling that I'll not get sukha if I give up my punya, and without the ego, you know, he drops of punya papa. So sahajata is understood by the Roma drishtanta, Ashwa Roma drishtanta. So punya papa which have been dropped paratra avasthana sapekshatva, where are these punya papa going to go if he has dropped? If it is burnt, there is no such akanksha, but then if it is dropped as mentioned, then there is an apeksha ऑफ परत्र अवस्थान, वेर आर दे गोइंग टू स्टे नाउ, पुण्य पाप परैहि उपादानम आवश्यकम इति भाव, पिकिंग अप बाय अदर्स इज डेफिनेटली नीडेड, देर इज डेफिनेट नेसेसिटी ऑफ सच काइंड ऑफ अ सप्लिकेशन टू सच आकांक्षा वेन जस्ट दि हान इज हर्ड. शाखान्तरस्तोपि विशेषः शाखान्तरे अपि अपेक्षितः उपसंहरणीयः इत्यत्र दृष्टान्तमः. इवन इफ इट इज इन अ डिफरेंट शाखा इट हैज टू बी ब्रॉट टुगेदर. हाउ सो? फॉर दैट सम एग्जांपल्स आर गिवन. विच आर दोज एग्जांपल्स? द फोर दैट वी सॉ, कुशा छंद स्तुति एंड उपगान. सो कुशा छंद स्तुत्युपगानवत, कुशावत छंदोवत स्तुतिवत उपगानवत, लाइक द कुशा छंद छंदस स्तुति एंड उपगान. ईच ऑफ दीज आर गोइंग टू बी एलोबरेटेड नाउ एज टू वॉट आर दीज एग्जाम्पल्स वेर इन अनदर शाखा शाखांतर ऑल्सो इफ देर इज आकांक्षा फुलफिल्ड यू हैव टू डू उपसंहार. तत्र यथा कुशा वानस्पत्याः इति भाल्लविनां श्रुतौ कुशानां अविशेषेण वनस्पति यूनित्व श्रवणे शाट्यानिनां औदुम्बरा इति विशेषवचनात् औदुम्बर्याः कुशाः आश्रियन्ते. फर्स्ट एग्जाम्पल इज एक्सप्लेन. सो वेन कुशा कुशा वानस्पत्याः इन दि भाल्लवी शाखा भाल्लव शाखा व्हाट डू यू हियर दि फॉर जप संख्या संख्या दि वनस्पति हैज टू बी यूज कुशाः वानस्पत्याः. दि कुशा आर मेड फ्रॉम वनस्पति वनस्पति इति भाल्लवीनां श्रुतौ. वेन यू हियर दिस इन दैट श्रुति व्हाट डू यू हैव कुशानां अविशेषेण. नो विशेष हैज बीन वनस्पति. विच वनस्पति हैज नॉट बीन मेंशन्ड. यू नो लाइक यू पिक अप सम पैक्ड फूड एंड यू सी इट देयर सम वनस्पति मेंशन्ड सम ऑयल देयर इज ए वेजिटेबल ऑयल. विच वेजिटेबल यू डोंट नो. सम ऑयल विल बी मेंशन्ड देयर. And unfortunately, it is not going to be ghee. Unfortunately, it is going to be the cheapest of the oils which are not good for health. This is what we see when you pick up, you know, in a mall, you pick up something and you see, you know, vegetable oil. So, you know, when vegetable oil, specifically some oil has not been mentioned there, you know, it is going to be palm oil. It is not going to be, groundnut oil or something like that. It is going to be the cheapest of the available. It is going to be palm oil, not good for health. Just an aside, it came to mind, so I mentioned. But when it is mentioned vegetable oil, what comes to mind? Oh, which vegetable it is? Of course, someone they may mention vanaspati. Earlier era, we wouldn't have so many flavors of oil that is available today. Due to all this, you know, WTO and all sorts of oils being sold to India. But vanaspati would be mentioned. So earlier, we just have had a choice of whether it is ghee or vanaspati. Or some oil, then it would be, you know, mostly it would be groundnut oil. At home, it would be til oil. But then, when you are looking for some pure product, the akanksha was what? Is it ghee or is it vanaspati? And that vanaspati is what? Basically dalda. It's a brand, but then that's how it was famous. It's a brand, but then the just like Xerox, you know, photocopy is called as Xerox because being first is better than being the best, some marketing principles. So dalda is a company now, but then although it is a brand, then the vanaspati, the vegetable fat, was called as dalda. Even if you old generation, earlier generation, you see they'll talk about dalda. So this is the expectancy as to what is the kusha to be made of. That is the example. With an aside also, that's the example. So kusha vanaspatyaha, when you see which vanaspati has been used, that akansha comes up. Which should be used? Can I make it with any vriksha? Any vriksha, can I use it for some pieces of wood? And those kushas I can use for japa sankhya. But then Shruti says that if you use a particular vanaspati, then there is an adrishta phala. To get the count going, drishta phala is definitely there. You know how many, so you have done three malas count is possible even with, you know, even with grains of rice also, if you count, you'll attain the drishta phala. But adrishta phala you'll get only when you use a particular vanaspati. Therefore, those who are mimamsakas, they'll have this for adrishta, they are longing. Therefore, there is an akanksha. Iti bhallavi naam shrutav kushanam avisheshana. There is no vishesha given of vanaspati. Vanaspati yonitra shravane. Shravane sati. When there is a shravana of yonitva meaning karanatva, which is the karana? Karana is vanaspati. Karana meaning the material cause, upadana karana. The material for kusha has to be vanaspati. That vanaspati has been mentioned avisheshana. No specific vanaspati has been mentioned in the for the bhallavis. Then there is an expectancy which is fulfilled in another shaka. Shatyayanina audumbara iti. Audumbara vanaspati has to be used. Therefore, you can bring it and connect it here. Iti vishesha vachanad audumbaryaha kushaha ashriyante. Therefore, which kusha should you use? You should use audumbarya kusha. Yatha, then second example. Yatha chando vistuvataha ityatra devasura chandasama visheshena पौर्वापर्य प्रसंगे देवच्छन्दांसि पूर्वाणि इति पैंगी श्रुत्या प्रतीयते. सो नाउ इट सेज दैट यथा छंदो भी स्तुवता इत्यत्र. सो देयर इज अ सेक्शन वेयर छंदो भी द स्तुति स्तुति मेंशनड इज थ्रू छंद. Chandobhi, Tritiya has been used through Chandas. Ityatra, there, just a statement of what Chandobhi Stuvataha. Stuti has to be done with Chandas. That's all has been mentioned. So, which Chandas? Which Chandas? How many Akshara should be there? Nothing is known there. Ityatra, Devasura Chandas Samavisheshena Paurvaparya Prasange. So deva asura chanda sama visheshena. Deva and asura both are discussed there. So with the chandas the praise is done. So which chandas has to be used for devas, which for asuras? So paurva parya prasange deva chandamsi purvani. It says that actually there elsewhere it is mentioned Navaksharani, Chandamsi, Asurani, Anyani, Daivyani. So the nine Aksharas which are there, that kind of a Chandas is used for Asura. So they praise with Chandas as you mentioned. Chandovi Stuvataha, they praise with Chandas. With which Chandas, who is praised is not mentioned. इत्यत्र देवासुर छंद साम विशेषण देयर साम विशेष समान रूप हैज बीन मेंशन पौरापर प्रसंग इन द पर्टिकुलर पौरापर प्रसंग अर्लियर एंड लेटर व्हाट हैज बीन मेंशन इफ यू लुक एट इट इफ यू कंपेयर विच छंद हैज टू बी यूज्ड फॉर हूम इन दिस स्तुति और विच हैज बीन यूज्ड देयर पैंगी श्रुति कम्स टू रेस्क्यू इति देवच्छंदांसि पूर्वाणि. सो देयर बाय द पौर्वापर्य प्रसंग कम्स अप एज टू द प्रीसीडिंग एंड द फॉलोइंग. व्हाट इज इट इफ यू लुक एट इट पैंगी श्रुत्या प्रतीयते मीनिंग देवच्छंदांसि पूर्वाणि द देवच्छंद आर अर्लियर. So in the krama comes up as to which chandas has to be used for whom, that is known elsewhere. That is not mentioned here. So for that I mentioned Navaksharani, Chandamsi, Asurani, Anyani, Daivyani. So nine aksharas are there. That kind of a chandas is used for asuras and others are for devas. So from elsewhere you can bring that and understand as to how many letters are there in the chandas through which it is the praise is there. But you will find another context as to which is used for which. So now here in the Purvani has been mentioned. What has gone by earlier? Those chandas are for Devastuti. Iti Paingi Shrutya Prati. The Paingi Shruti has Vakya Sheshatva there, that particular Shruti. Yat So thereby what happens is that the krama, who is to be praised first there, deva should be praised first, asuras are praised later. This kind of a krama is understood. So for the example here is of the krama. The chandobhi stuvataha, they praise with chandas. So that shows that both devas and asuras are to be praised in a particular context. So who should be praised first, who should be praised later, there you know that devas are to be praised first, and then the stuti of the asuras. Yatha, then the third example, yatha shodashinaha पात्र विशेषस्य ग्रहणे अंगभूतं स्तोत्रं कदा कर्तव्यम् इत्यपेक्षायां छन्दोगानां काल विशेष अप्राप्तौ समयाध्युषिते सूर्ये इत्यादि तैत्तिरीय श्रुत्या काल विशेष प्रतीयते. सो द थर्ड एग्जांपल आउट ऑफ द फोर्थ इज व्हाट दिस षोडशी पात्र, यू हैव सीन दिस अर्लियर. षोडशी पात्र विशेष ग्रहण इज मेंशन्ड. So Angabhutram Stotra is also there, that Stotra, when the Patra is taken up, the Shodashi Patra is taken up, then its Anga is Stotra. When should that Stotra be chanted? Kada Kartavyam Stotra, when should the Stotra be chanted? Iti Apekshayam, when that Apeksha is there, Chandoganam Kala Vishesha Praptam. In the Chandogya Shruti, Kala Vishesha is not there. When it should be chanted, that is not been mentioned. At what time should you chant and basically you take up the patra also? No timing has been mentioned in Chandogya. However, samyadhyushite surye, not samya, samaya, samyadhyushite surye. So when the surya comes up, suryodaya samayetyartha, at the time of suryodaya, this stotra should be chanted, and thereby the shodashi patra grahana should be done with the stotra in the morning at suryodaya. This is, where do you hear this? In another shaka, shakantara ityadi taitariya shrutya, in the taitariya shruti it is heard, taitariya shaka, kala vishesha pratiyate, vishesha kala has been mentioned, therefore that has to be connected. The last example there is yatha ritvija upagayanti iti samanya vakyam shakantariyam na advaryu upagayati iti vishesha vachanam apeksha advaryu वर्जिता ऋत्विजः उपगायन्ति इत्येतत् अर्थपरतया निश्चीयते. सो नाउ द पूर्वपक्षी इज गिवन द फोर्थ एग्जांपल, लाइक व्हाट एल्स, हाउ टू कनेक्ट समथिंग, व्हाई टू कनेक्ट समथिंग फ्रॉम अनदर प्लेस, अनदर शाखा. लुक एट दिस फोर्थ एग्जांपल, लास्ट एग्जांपल इज ऋत्विजः उपगायन्ति, दि ऋत्विक. Ritviks are, there are three Ritviks, Advaryu, Hota, Udgata, Trayaha, Ritvijaha. So there are four Ritviks, three Ritviks, Trayaha, Advaryu is also Ritvik, Hota is a Ritvik, and Udgata, they belong to different Shakhas, different Vedas. So all these are Ritviks. So Ritvik, which Ritvik should do Upagana? When the Samagana is done, the Upagana, so you look at it, it is saying ऋत्विजा उपगायन्ति, द उपगाना इज डन बाय ऋत्विक्स, लिटरली इट मीन्स दे सिंग, ऋत्विक्स सिंग. सो ऋत्विक्स सिंग दैट हैज बीन मेंशन्ड इति सामान्य वाक्यम, दिस इज अ जनरल स्टेटमेंट. व्हाट डज इट मीन, ओ आर यू अ ऋत्विक, देन यू हैव टू सिंग. एंड अध्वर्यु इज अ ऋत्विक, होता इज अ ऋत्विक, एंड उपगाता सॉरी उद्गाता इज अ ऋत्विक. सो शुड ऑल ऑफ देम सिंग? Definitely, Ritvijaha Upagayanti, this shows that all the Ritviks should sing, whether it is an Advaryu, Hota or Udgata. Iti Samane Vakyam Shakantaryam Na Advaryu Upagayati, Advaryu does not do Upagana, has been mentioned elsewhere. Meaning he should not, Advaryu should not be doing Upagana, he should not be singing. Iti Vishesha Vachanam Apeksha, considering that statement elsewhere in another shakha, Advaryu Varjita Ritvija Upagayanti, what should be understood as all Ritviks should sing except Advaryu, meaning Hota and Udgata should sing. That's what it means. Even if you hear Ritvija Upagayanti, Advaryu should not be singing. Why? Because there is a dependency on another vakya which says that Na Advaryu Upagayati, Advaryu does not sing, should not sing. Latlakara there is in late meaning. विधिलिंग इति विशेष वचनम अपेक्षित है, डिपेंडेंसी ऑन अ पर्टिकुलर स्टेटमेंट वाक्यशेषत्व इज देर एंड देर बाय एक्सेप्ट फॉर अध्वर्यु ऑल ऋत्विज ऑल ऋत्विक्स उपगायन्ति अध्वर्यु वर्जिता ऋत्विज उपगायन्ति इति एतद् अर्थपरतया निश्चयते। सो कनेक्टिंग बोथ दी स्टेटमेंट्स इफ यू लुक एट दी मीनिंग इट विल ओनली मेक सेंस। इट इज नॉट दैट इन वन शाखा दी अध्वर्यु ऑल्सो सिंग्स एंड इन अनदर शाखा अध्वर्यु डज नॉट सिंग। You put them together and you see that all ritviks except Advaryu sing in both shakhas. Evancha yatha kushadishu shrutyantaragata visheshanvayaha tatha hanu upayana anvayaha iti siddham. Now he is connecting to the exemplified. Just like these four examples, kushadi examples are seen where there is a dependency on another shakha. Antaragata statement vakya sheshatva is there. Shrutyantaragata visheshanvaya. Visheshanvaya should be done. As Vakya Shesha, you should put together as a single Vakya, even if they are in different Shrutis, different Shakhas, Tata. Similarly, what? Hanu Upayana Anvaya Iti Siddha. This Upayana Shabda should be brought in from same Shakha or another Shakha also and connected in the Hana Sannidhi. This has been established. Iti Siddham, it is established. We'll finish this couple of lines left. In the first interpretation, we look at the rest in the नेक्स्ट पार्ट है। श्रुत्यंतर्गतम ही विशेषम श्रुत्यंतरे अनभ्युपगच्छत सर्वत्र अष्टदोष दुष्ट विकल्प स्यात्। आई विल एक्सप्लेन दिस लेटर। देर आर एट दोषास इफ एट ऑल और नॉट इफ एट ऑल इट इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेड मीनिंग इफ यू डू नॉट एक्सेप्ट दिस देन देर विल बी एट फ्लॉज मीनिंग जस्ट लुक एट दिस श्रुत्यंतर्गतम ही विशेषम द स्पेसिफिक मेंशन इन अनदर वाक्य इन अनदर श्रुति if it is not connected to swashakha where that particular thing has not been mentioned. Let's just take one example, the last one. This Advaryu is also a Ritvik, and if you take Ritvija Upagayanti means Advaryu sings. Advaryu is also Ritvik, he also sings, and in another shakha it is mentioned Advaryu na Upagayati, so he does not sing. Now what can be the meaning? It can be that in one shakha one sings and in another shakha that Advaryu does not sing. But then Mimamsa is what? When you see at one place it is allowed, another place it is not allowed for the Ritvik to sing, this particular Advaryu to sing, then it is optional. That can be the meaning. So if you take the optional meaning, what is the optional meaning? The Advaryu who is a Ritvik may or may not sing. That's the optionality. So if you do that, then what will happen if you do not take that? If you do not accept the Vishesha in the other Shruti, you interpret it any which way later, but if you do not take that Vishesha, Shrutyantar Gatam Hi Vishesham, Shrutyantare Anubhyupagachata Sarvatrashta Dosha Dushta Vikalpa Syat, then the Vikalpa will be what? Ashta Dosha Dushta. It will be tainted with the eight flaws. If you do not accept the particular mention in another Shruti, in another shaka, this is what the Siddhanti is saying. What these eight doshas are there, taduktam, that has been mentioned in Jaimini shaka, Jaimini sutra, not Jaimini shaka, sorry, Jaimini sutra, Purvamimamsa sutra, and that ashtadoshas will I'll explain in the next part. Such a, I'll just mark it so that I'll continue here. Such a anyayaha satyam gatau taduktam dvadasha lakshanyam jaiminina vipratishede vikalpasyatiti. So it has been iti pratham varnakam. So it has been mentioned in Jaimini Sutra, Dwadasha Lakshanyam Sutra. There are 12 chapters in Jaimini Purvamimamsa Sutras. There in Vipratishede Vikalpasya, that kind of a that sutra, under that these eight doshas have been mentioned. Sacha anyayaha satyam gato. So if you take that, then it is not logical. If you do not take this option, meaning what? If you don't accept the particularity in another shakha when a general statement is there in your shakha, then you will land up with eight kind of flaws, because optionality has been mentioned. If you take it, optionality also, that has to be taken into consideration. For that also you have to accept the anya shakha antargata vakya, which is opposed to your statement, your shakha statement. Meaning Vipratisheda is there. If there is a Vipratisheda, then what is that? You cannot just say that I am okay with this because in my shaka this has been mentioned, therefore this alone is the right way, meaning I will chant adhvaryu, I the adhvaryu, in my shakha it has been mentioned rutvijaha upagayanti, so upagana I the adhvaryu will do. If this is the option you take, then what it means is that vishesha, it has been mentioned upa na adhvaryu upagayati in another shakha, there you will say, oh, I don't accept that. If you don't accept that, then what will happen? Vipratishede vikalpa syat. This has been mentioned. When there is a vipratisheda, then vikalpa, it has to be taken at least as an optionality. If you do not do that, then there will be eight doshas. What these eight doshas are there, we'll see in the next part. And we'll look at the second interpretation of this sutra in the next part. It is a long sutra. It will take a little time. I wanted to skim through, but unfortunately, I can't do it. So I have to spend some time research a bit and explain, but so be it. It is as far as possible I'll try to explain whatever my little understanding is of this section. Okay, and we'll look at the second interpretation, which will be faster because we have covered most of it in the first interpretation. Amnayante samsiddham adi madhyant varjitam anandaghanam apurnam atma jyoti rupasmahe. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada Upanji, namaste.
Dhanyavada.